Hi, my name's Em and I'm the founder of Holly & Co. Pet accessories and stuff for people. I don't actually know what our slogan is, but that's what it is today. So we're going to make a million bow ties, aren't we, Jem?
Oh, yeah.
Clickbait title. We're going to make stuff for our collection coming out Thursday. It's called Why You're So Obsessed With Me Collection. And we're just going to see how many bows we can make. And I'm going to show you, I guess, our process of bulk making them. Oh, and by the way, I actually do have templates. Someone commented and said, oh, you should, you know, make templates for your bow so you don't have to use a measuring tape every time. I don't. Imagine using a measuring tape every time, how long that would take. I have templates. I just don't show them in the tutorials because I feel like I want to show people how they're going to make it, if that makes sense. So I do have templates, and that's how we make them. Oh, and by the way, I cut all my hair off. So, tutorial on hair cutting coming soon. I'm totally kidding. So, let's just get started, and we will just do some in real time, and then I'll speed it up, because there's going to be a lot, and we'll see how many we can do. So these are all the fabrics. I showed them the other day, all our haul, and I'm gonna make the double bow. I'm gonna actually release that for this collection. I don't particularly want to make them, but we don't tell people that, do we, Jen?
No.
So I'm just gonna start with a rayon. Why not? Let's do that. I'm gonna try and cut all of it, maybe. I got 2 meters of each, I think, so I'm gonna try my best to just cut all of it. I'll turn my iron on. So these are my templates. I've got just regular and large, and the sailor piece, and then the body. And I have a king size, but I never use it because it uses all my fabric, and I think that the king size is ridiculous. I'll show you for comparison. So this is your large compared with your medium, which is what I've been making for the tutorials. This is the king size. It's comical. It's comical sized. People always want them, but unless I'm charging $500 for a bow tie, it's not gonna happen. Because look at that. It's using like half a meter of fabric. I'm not here for that. So put that one away. And we'll start with the regular. I don't know whether to make more regular or more large. What do we sell more of?
Regular?
Yeah, we'll make some more regular than large. So this is what I do. I grab my rotary blade and I fold it over so that I can cut, you know, double at one time. Boom, boom, boom. I also sort of cut a bit outside of my templates because they've been cut a lot. I mean, look at this. It's not straight at all. So, and then I just have a giant piece like that, and then later I'll go in and I'll cut them all in half. And that's how we get more done in less time. Work smarter, not harder. Isn't that right, Jen?
Absolutely.
If we can cut corners, we will. And as you can see, Spotlight does not cut their fabric straight at all. You think that with their little tables with the straight line that they would, but no. They don't know how to cut a straight line. Six. Eight. Ten. And then I might fit a sail piece in there, so I'll just cut that bit off the top. Throw that out. That was where Spotlight did not cut straight. And then I'll do another row of that. So I'll get 20 and then I'll do a row of large. I'll probably do two of large, but obviously I won't get 10 across. And then I'll cut all the sailor pieces, and if there's anything left over, maybe I'll do scrunchies.
I can feel a tutorial of scrunchies.
I can feel another tutorial coming on.
We should do, actually, because we make our scrunchies different to other people.
Actually, like this scrunchie that I'm wearing. We do it like that. Not that their sewing is very good. Look at this. I want to show this up close. This is from Ali Fashion and it was $2.
Totally not my
Look at their sewing. Oh dear. Anyway, I love getting stuff from a, you know, like a big global store and the sewing shit, and you think, really? They sold it like that.
That's why it was $2.
That's why it was $2. Yeah. But that's why you buy from small business and not big corporations, because small business take the time to, like, we would cut that off. If we were making scrunchies, we wouldn't just sell it like that. So that's why you buy from small business and not big business. Because we care. I'm going to leave this piece up here somewhere. I'll use it later for sale pieces. So I've done 20 regulars. I've got that left. A bit over a meter, I reckon. So I'm going to do my large now. Try and do two rows of that. So, selvage, bye. One, two, large. I'll put it in a separate pile over there. If you're wondering what size the large bow is, I have no idea. We spent ages, actually, didn't we, Jen, coming up with the different sizes to make sure it's proportionate, because I hate some bows you'll see and they got super long tails compared to the top, and that's just not it for me. So we spent ages measuring, creating, recreating. So this is our little secret, these measurements. 2, 4, 6, 8. I wasn't getting 8 large across and then extra for the sailor piece. So we'll have 16 larges and 20 regulars in each. And how many fabrics are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. How many is that? So that's 180 bows. That's nearly a million. Same thing, really. It'll feel like it. So we're going to give it a go and do 180 bows. We probably won't finish them today. Right, so I don't actually, there's still a fair bit left. I don't know. I don't know if I've left enough for sailor pieces, but that's okay. I can just cut up some stuff, I suppose. So I cut one on the fold, like a bear, and then I just pulled fabric down and then cut it on the half, so then you're getting double, like I was with the top, if that makes sense. But we now have an odd amount, so I'm actually going to cut that bit in there just so that it's even. So I don't think there's actually going to be enough, to be honest. I think I went a little bit heavy handed, but I'm going to try my best. Scrap. Oops. Can you pick that up, please? 17. 18. When I dropped this on the ground, it ruined it.
Just saying.
Yeah, because now it won't cut properly. I don't want to waste the blade. Well, 19, 20-ish Right. And now I've got to try and get 16 out of that. Actually, maybe. That's a fair bit. Leave your comments down below. Do you think Emily will have enough fabric? I'm going to have to change the blade in that because I ruined it by dropping it on the floor.
And they're expensive and you just bought it. So I know. Stop.
Fresh blade, don't drop it on the ground. Oh, cutting through it like butter. Right, so I've got two of them. Four. Six. Eight. Nine. So that's 10. I don't think I'm going to get six out of this, so I might have to cut one of the bows as one. Maybe. No, I don't think so. 11, 12, 13. So I'm going to get 14, and then if I just cut one of the largest down and use it as a sailor, then I only need 15, I guess. So I'll cut that in half. So I've now got that. And then I'll just use that as a sailor piece. So 15 large and 20 regular. Boom. Like that. And you're probably thinking, wow, that didn't take very long. Oh, but now we've just got to cut all the lining and all the interfacing and all the velvet middles. So... We literally came into the office, didn't even bring the bows, didn't even bring them, what the hell. So the girl Friday, my dad the trooper, he's gonna bring them in for us.
What do you think about it, Jen?
I think that we're very lucky to have him and I'm waiting to do our shit work.
So for the next half an hour, we're just gonna, what are we gonna do? I don't know.
We can do this.
We've got a wholesale order. Actually, we'll do that. So we'll do a wholesale order, but yeah. This is what happens behind the scenes because we make the bows at home and then forget to bring them into the bloody office anyway. So that's the tea. That's happy Monday.
You hold that. I'll get out.
Sweet Karen. So we have bandana, large, medium, small.
One of each.
Yep. A pink velvet bow regular. Holly floral collars, I don't know.
Okay.
Blush pink harness, extra small. Two. A small, a medium, and a large in harness. Two extra small denim blue harnesses. One small, which I think is our last one.
Yay!
And a medium and a large. And holly floral harness, one extra small. They're here. Hello. Oh.
Hello.
A what?
Extra small, small, medium, large.
Just one of these.
Yeah. And finally, one denim blue bow sailor regular.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's it.
Let's go.
Let's do rivets.
Best part about working for yourself, getting a beanbag in the office and looking out the window and stalking everybody.
I just wanted to say how well received our tutorials have been, because we wanted to do them for a long time but just not really sure whether it was a good idea or not, but the feedback has been awesome. People have been really, really nice about it, and so thankful that we're giving our knowledge away for free, pretty much, and giving our secrets away and stuff. And I know that not everyone is able to buy our products, not everyone has the access to that, so I think it's good that people are able to do it their own at home. People are just being really supportive and really, really nice, and so grateful. Except, unfortunately, we've had a little bit of negativity from other businesses, which kind of sucks.
Jen's come to join.
I have.
So I was just saying that
our tutorials were super positive and that everyone's been really nice about it. But the only negativity that we did receive was from other businesses, which is disappointing.
I think they feel that they're threatened, but I don't know why. I think it's like, we've given their secrets away as well, but I don't know why they feel like that, because they've already got their customers.
Yeah.
They're loyal customers.
Yeah.
A lot of people can't sew.
Well, that's true.
Unless you've got a sewing machine, you can't do it anyway.
Because I had a couple of other businesses message me when we first did the bow tutorial and say, why are you giving all your secrets away?
But they're not secrets. Like, you can go on YouTube yourself.
Well, that's right. And thinking that we were going to close down or something, and you're not going to sell any bows now. And we released Bespoke bows the other day, and we sold just as many as we always do. And people were saying, like, I'm always going to buy from you because A, I don't have a sewing machine, or B, I don't want to make my own bows. I'm too lazy or don't have time or whatever. So I don't see it as an issue. Plus, I look at it as there's a million and one scrunchie tutorials out there, and scrunchies are super easy to make, yet there's a million and one successful scrunchie businesses.
And I've seen people doing the
Kokodamas.
Yeah, Kokodamas.
Jewellery.
Successful Kokodama business, and they do workshops. And same with earrings and things like that. So I think it's the businesses that aren't confident in themselves how to do it. Instead of just pulling up their big girl panties and getting on with it. Don't worry about what we're doing. Right. Worry about what you're doing.
So we're going to release a bunch more tutorials. We're going to do leashes and harnesses and strap harnesses and crew bags.
Bandanas.
Yeah. Because I just think we want it to be accessible to everyone. As I said, not everyone can afford our stuff or wants to buy from us. A lot of people want to hand make their own things, so I think it's good. You know, people messaging and saying, oh, it's giving me something to do while I'm off from surgery or COVID or whatever. So, I don't know. I think it's a good thing. But
absolutely.
You know, some people don't see it that way.
But anyway, no. But I don't care what they think. It wouldn't matter what we did.
There he is. The man of the hour. It's Rossco. Thank you.
That's quite alright.
We fucked up. Thank you, Rossco.
Okay. Look how cute this box is. What was even in that? Cookies?
The two cookies.
Cookies. Look how cute it is. This is our DIY bow box. Someone bought one. They also bought six of our bows as well, which just reiterates what we said before about people panicking that, you know, we're not gonna sell anything anymore. So I'll show you what comes in one in case you wanted to buy one.
line it with tissue paper. Okay, so first things first, you get your fabric. This person bought the Taylor, I think it was called. And you get your three different fabrics, the lining fabric, and your iron-on interfacing. So we'll pop that in there, that way. Get instructions, which links to our YouTube video. Because we're paperless, you don't need waste of paper. You get one reel of Gutermann, best thread ever, and a needle. So pop that in there. You get a measuring tape. This is a Holly & Co branded measuring tape, by the way, so it's not just your ordinary crap. 30 centimeters of elastic in 6mm width. And you get three made with love little tags. I don't know if you can see that, but you get three of those.
And you do need a sewing machine.
Yes.
You could sew it by hand if you know how to hand sew. Don't know, and glue. I don't know how strong it would be. But if you're just going to use it for photos and just to see how you go with making it, well, then you could.
Yes, and you need scissors, obviously. An iron, you do need that for the iron on your interfacing, but you could technically just sew the interfacing together, so you don't really need an iron, I guess, but
to make it look nice,
suggest it. And then we put our little sleeve over the top, and then we have our sleeve on like so. Very professional. And they also bought all these bows, which just goes to show that showing a tutorial how to make something and also offering DIY stuff doesn't make people stop buying your stuff. So just do it. When your poo bags match this person's order, the purple and the orange, it looks stunning. Oh, and also my nails match too. Oh, that's cute. But yeah, we think about it. We totally plan everything. Look how cute this order is. Love it.